Glory to God. Amen, amen, and amen. Hallelujah. Good morning, everybody. I just bless the name of the Lord for our lives. I trust that we're doing well. This morning, I want to read from, it was a promise from, I picked a promise, and it just resonated strongly, and I want to share from that. And then there's a song that God has been, thank you, darling. There's a song that God has been placing on my heart for a bit since last night. And I would also share that in a bit. So let's open our Bible to the book of 1 Kings 5. 1 Kings 5. Thank you, Jesus. 1 Kings 5. You know that my father David was not able to build a temple to honor the name of the Lord his God, because of the many wars waged against him by surrounding nations. He could not build until the Lord gave him victory over all his enemies. But now, somebody say, but now. Somebody put but now in the chat. Come on, let's do this. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But now, but now, but now, but now. But now, let's see how many but nows we have. Hallelujah. So there's been a season of battle. David could not do something, but now the Lord my God has given me peace on every side. I have no enemies and all is well. So I am planning to build a temple to honor the name of the Lord my God, just as he had instructed my father. The Lord told me, your son who I will place on your throne will build the temple to honor my name. Looking at our build, arise and build, to honor my name. See, but now it's God, that but now is introducing a change of season. And I want to announce to us this morning, we're in a new season. But now was introducing a shift. He said, but now the Lord my God has given me peace on every side. I have no enemies. The question is, wow, it makes sense. Yesterday I was on a prayer call and I said, God should give us, let's pray for peace. I'm telling you that we need to come into the place of peace to be able to effectually build that which God is giving to us. God is saying that some of you have been fighting. Now God is saying it's time to build. It's time to build. It's time to build. Oh, it's time to build. It's time to build. 1 Kings 5. From verse 3 to 5. It's time to build. The strategy has changed. The strategy has changed. What do I mean by that? There's a way you can be in the war and all your mind is attack, fight, defense. And now God is saying you're in a season now that your weapon now that you're picking up is the weapon to build. Is the ideas, is the instructions, is the strategy that God is giving. I don't know if this encourages anyone. To even think with what we're going through as a nation, as a people. I don't know who I'm talking. This is why I felt like there are people that have been through, hey, my God, high and low waters. People have been through some difficult situation. But now, it's time to build. But now, it's time to arise and build. But now, it's time to build. God has given you peace on every side. That means that God is going to be any PTSD, anything that you have, picked up along the way, anything that has affected you. I love this. Well, now God has provided peace all around. No one against us, nothing at all with us. I love this. MSB, what's that? What translation is that? You know, there's a way you can be in a place where you've fought for a long time. You don't know how not to fight in a particular way. And now the message, oh, thank you. That's so good. How come I didn't see that? Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Now I'm looking for the four. Now, God has provided peace all around. No one against us. Nothing at odds with us. I love it. Nothing at odds with us. Some of you, God is saying, I want to introduce peace. And this kind of peace I love to call is shalom. You know, when they say shalom, shalom, shalom is not just, oh, peace alone. It's saying that peace be, as a result of there is no problem all around. Peace because there is provision, there's divine health. This shalom consists of not just, oh, peace. When we just translate shalom as just, oh, it's just peace. No, the kind of peace that gives room for everything. Every blessing. Oh, shakala da 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 da. So God is saying to somebody, you have to learn what I'm about to do in this season. Because you are used to attack, you're used to fighting, you're used to, you know. And God is saying, listen, I'm about to visit you. He says, shalom. Is Hebrew word meaning peace, harmony, wholeness, completeness, prosperity, welfare, and tranquility. Is all encompassing. That's where we are. He said, the Lord has provided peace all around. I'm speaking to somebody, peace all around, so you can download strategies, ideas, and get up and build. Peace all around so you can step into the realms of faith to believe. Peace all around so that you know that this peace will make you have quiet in your spirit. I'm going to play the song, but we're going to pray. You're going to say, Lord, I have peace all around. Nothing missing, nothing broken. It's your season of harvest. It's your season of reward. Is your season of blessing? Is your season of increase? Because you see, a lot of, I keep hearing that. That's what it's just coming to my heart over and over again. That a lot of people do not know what to do with abundance. You have been at war. You've struggled with lack. Now God is saying that, oh, it's your season of life. Some people, you don't know what to do. How do you navigate that? What do I do with that information? I'm used to managing. I'm used to fighting. I'm used to, you know, and God is saying now, I've given you peace all around. No one against us. Nothing at odd with us in the name of Jesus. Before we sing that song, we're going to open our mouth wherever we are. I say, Lord, I step into this season of peace. I keep hearing this, that you are used to, and you're used to maybe the last word you got in the last season. You are so used to it that you are not able to see what God is doing in this season. Maybe the same God that told you stand still is not telling you go forward. But because you for years, you have been at this spot, you have been at this place, you're used to fighting this way, you're used to, you know, whatever it is, there's an upgrade. God is calling you into a place that, you know what, the next weapon is going to be peace. The next season, is this season, is going to be peace on all sides. You're used to just from hand to mouth. You're used to just manna, just enough. God is saying, I'm bringing you to the land flowing with milk and honey, where I will teach you how to make wealth. I will give you grace to create. I will give you grace to build. I will give you grace to expand. I will give you grace to write out, to do proposals, to go out there, to do some, I don't know what this is for, some intense application. For sending benefits. So, but I'm going to be with you. I'm going to teach you. I'm going to be with you. I'm going to teach you. I'm giving you peace on all sides. He said, David could not build. There's some things that you could not build in the last season. Who am I speaking to? I received that for myself. There's some things you could not, because it was an intense season of internal battles, an intense season of external battles. David, my father, was not able to build a temple in honor of God because of the wars he had to fight on all sides until God finally put them down. Because of the war, because of the battle, because of the breaking out, you are contending, because of the contention, because of the things that you have had to face, confront, because of the people you've had to build, because of the systems you've had to create. You could not build certain things. But now, I am in my but now season. But now, there's another part. I just came to my spot. Now, God remembered the children of Israel. But now, God remembered all my labor of love. But now, God remembered the tears. But now, God remembered the seeds and the harvest and the sacrifices. But now, wherever you are, please, I want you to unmute your mics and begin to decree. It's my but now season. Everything I could not do in this last season, I am doing them with grace in this new season.
Jesus' name of prayer. Amen.
I want to share with us now briefly the song. I was still going to pray. I want somebody to hold fast to this promise as it go through today. But now I will arise and build. Because what Solomon was doing was Solomon was sending a letter to ask for a fine kind of wood. They're sending people that only a certain kind of people could cut in a beautiful way, the way he wanted. And that's what he was writing to explain, to tell them. I see some of you, but now you enjoy favor. Favor that you have not maybe enjoyed before. Some doors that the Lord has kept preserved up until now. in this season. But now those doors are open to you. But now favor has come for you in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we thank you. Glory to God.
Clap your hands, everybody. Come on. If God's been faithful, then sing along with us. Everybody say faithful.
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 Faithful,
faithful,
faithful
is our God.
Is our God.
Come on, all over the world.
Faithful.
Say faithful.
Faithful,
faithful,
faithful
is our God.
Is our God.
Come on, say faithful.
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 Faithful is our God.
Faithful is our God.
Yes, He is. Come on, say faithful.
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 Faithful,
faithful,
faithful
is our God.
Is our God.
I'm reaping the harvest.
I'm reaping the harvest God promised me.
Take back what the devil stole from me. And I rejoice today.
For
I shall recover it all. Yes, I rejoice today.
We're going to use that song now to pray. How many of you were blessed by that? And I kept that part. I'm reaping the harvest God promised me. Take back what the devil stole from me. And I will rejoice, not tomorrow, today, for I shall recover it all. And that's what happened to this summer. David had fought. And now Solomon is living in the harvest of his father by experiencing peace on every side. So you're going to unmute your mic wherever you are and declare, I will rejoice today because I'm reaping the harvest God promised me. I'm taking back everything the devil stole from me in the name of Jesus. Can we open our mouth and begin to pray? It is a new season. Therefore, Lord, I'm reaping every harvest. I'm reaping the harvest God promised me. I take back anything the devil has stolen from me. And people up as the devil stolen from anybody this on this platform. I take back every opportunity, every resource, every support, every the devil has tried to intercept. I am reaping the harvest.
We recover all the
Finally, this morning, I want you to pray for Ayari of 365, where friends pray. And let's just pray the blessings of God over this platform and pray the Lord everything we need, all the resources, all the human power, all the favor the Lord God will provide in the name, all the outreach that is going to happen. The Lord will make it, will provide, and you will raise men. It will provide. It will pray blessing, testimonies from this ministry. Can we open our mouth and just begin to bless IRA and bless Hope 365, bless When Friends Speak? Can we open our mouth? Bless this platform and connected to you. Lord, we say we recover all in the name of Jesus. Father Lord, I thank you for this platform. I just want to read that prayer, pray that scripture again up over your life, that you have, you that have not been able to do certain things in your last season because you had wars you had to fight. You that have had to fight wars, internal wars, external wars, people that have had to go through dark seasons. You've had to, you know, some of it's not because it's dark seasons, they are God seasons. You've gone through night seasons, you've persevered, you kept building, even though you didn't see what it is, you kept fighting, you kept contending that the will of God be done. You kept releasing yourself as available vessel. You kept releasing your fund to fund kingdom projects. You kept, you know, just kept on. It says, but now God has provided peace. No, before then, he said, until God finally put them down. God has put your enemies down. But now God has provided peace all around. No one against you. No odds at you in the name of Jesus. Nothing at odds with you in the name of Jesus. I decree you will come back with testimonies of this scripture that you will look around and be like, wow, peace all around. Peace all around. Peace all around in the name of Jesus. The Lord has given you peace in the name of Jesus. The Lord has given you peace. The Lord has given you peace in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we bless you. We give you all the praise. If you receive it this morning, I want you to declare, I receive it. I receive it. I'm walking in my season, a new season, peace all around. Prosperity all around in the name of Jesus. Oh, thank you, Lord 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 Jesus. We receive it. Favor all around in the name of Jesus. Favor all around. Peace all around in the name of Jesus. Everywhere you turn, peace is a new season. Congratulations. So now, if it's a new season, you ask the Lord, what is the instruction for this new season? How do I unlock? You unlock the blessings of this season through by obeying instructions. So our ears will hear the instructions in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. God bless you all. Have a great, great, great day.
Two of these children that have been coming around, I'm assuming, I don't know if these guys are twins, but what I can see is that these two boys, they are wearing a shirt. And on that shirt, I see Caleb, then the other one, I see Zion. So I don't know.
Joyce is here. Those are children. They are not twins. One is Caleb, one is Aaron.
Oh, they are twins.
No, they are not twins. But they are not twins, but yeah. But they actually think they are twins. Go ahead, Joyce. Yeah,
those are my sons. They're 12 months apart.
Okay. Looking at them, they look like twins, and they are literally wearing the same clothes from what I'm seeing, and I see that name on the clothes. So my guess is that's their name. But there is something that one of them is saying to me. It looked like he's speaking on behalf of the two of them, but he said, we are around here to make some impact just like our dad. And he said, he doesn't get why people can't see all the signs around. Okay? That's the word. But then, as you know, he was saying that, he was showing me a card, a small yellow card. And it's almost like he's showing me to say, look, this sign has always been there, but it's almost like people are not just paying attention. And I'm looking at the card. There's the only thing I can see on that card is just two numbers, 2 and 7. I don't know if it's 27 or it's 2 and 7 is what I can say. I don't know if it's one whole number, but you know, it's just showing me, said, look, this sign has always been there.
You see, they are both born on the 27th. Caleb and the dad were both born on the 27th.
Oh, okay. Because he said, look, this sign has always been there. He said, we are around here and we need to make some impact, just like our dad. He said, but people are not getting it. He said, but the signs have always been there. And, you know, he just flashed that card. And I pray in the name of Jesus that all that these children, Caleb, sorry, remind me the name of the second one. These Zion. Two, Caleb and Zion, all that they have come to do, that you have commissioned them to do in terms of impact, even beyond what you have empowered their father to do and do in his lifetime, Lord, you will grant them the grace to do. Lord, you will grant them the power to do. Lord, you will grant them the discipline to do it. In the name of Jesus. Imarush takabala masuke bae. Aina masambara katali guburundi. Kabalito zekete libaya. Elande moshekete bruma santa labaya kadabaya. Leko robo sete liba. I like us to just pray again.